فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
Are you there? Run away. A brother will come up to you and he will say to you, Akhi, I go to clubs, I stand in front of them and I give people da'wah. Okay. You run away for your religion first. You protect yourself. Huh? Dar'ul mafsadati awla min jalb al-maslaha. Repelling evil takes precedence over bringing any good. Sah? And it's happened. I know a brother who used to do that. He now is a person who works in that club. He works in that same club he used to tell us, stand in front of Itqillah, Muslim, fear Allah. He works there. I know him. Ah. Be careful, brothers. Be careful. ولذلك, one of the things I, subhanAllah, I benefited from was Sheikh Abdul Karim al-Khudayr. Do you know him? Yeah? Sheikh Abdul Karim al-Khudayr, he said he brought a phone. You know, a smartphone. Smartphone. He said, I brought a smartphone. Okay? And then, you know, Sheikh, you know, he put the phone on one day and he wanted to check through his phone and get something out. And then pop came a picture of a woman. The woman was just not wearing a hijab, that's it. For us, that's normal, right? That's normal. These are Ahlul Ilm, people of knowledge. So what he did was, he threw the phone. And then he said, I got rid of the smartphone and I bought a dumb phone. Those little old phones, you know, that if they hit the floor or the earth or the ground, they bounce up. You remember those phones? Nah, he brought those phones. And then I asked him, I said, Sheikh, come on. Isn't that a bit extreme? I called him, I said, Sheikh, isn't it a bit extreme to let your phone go? I mean, it's got a lot of masalih in there, it's got a lot of khair in there, it's a lot of benefits in there. You can learn hadith from there, you can learn sunan, you can learn khair out of it. He said to me, Dar'ul mafsadati awla min jalbil maslaha. Repelling evil takes precedence of bringing any good. All that which you mentioned are good, but I have to first get rid of the evil. Does that make sense? Wallahi. So now he has the small little phones. Those are people who run away from what? Al-firaru min al-fitani. Running away from what? Trials and tribulations. Protect your religion. Ah. You know why? Because this is your ra'sul mal. Ma ma'na ra'sul mal? If you got business, what's the money that you look after the most? The profit or the capital? Which one do you give precedence to? The capital. Your religion is your capital. Bringing the people into the religion and guiding the people is a profit. First of all, I have to give precedence to the capital. Now.
حدثنا عبد الله بن مسلمة.
عبد الله بن مسلمة القعنبي. من تلامذته. He's from the students of who? Imam Malik ibn Anas ibn Rahi رضي الله. And he narrated from him Muwatta. He's got a riwayah. Riwayat al-Qa'nabi. There's a riwayah of his. But the riwayah that's very famous today that people study from Muwatta Imam Malik is riwayat of Yahya ibn Yahya al-Laythi. صح? And that's the riwayah that Imam Ibn Abdul Barr explains in his kitab al-Tamheed and also in his kitab al-Istithkar. What's the difference between al-Tamheed and al-Istithkar? They're both an explanation of Muwatta Imam Malik. What's the difference? The difference between al-Tamheed and al-Istithkar. What's the difference? The Tamheed, it talks about the narrations which are marfu'at, and Istithkar talks about the narrations which are mawqufat. Naam. Naam.
An Malik, an Abdurrahman ibn Abdullah ibn Abdurrahman ibn Abi Sa'sa, an Abi, an Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, annahu qala.
Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, his name is Sa'ad ibn Malik ibn Sinan. Al-Khazraji al-Ansari. And he was from the Sigar al-Sahaba. He's from the young Sahabas in terms of age. But he was from the Min Khiyarihim, those honorable ones and righteous ones. And he was Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, Min al-Huffaz, those who memorized a lot. And he spread a lot of the knowledge. And he taught a lot. Naam.
Annahu qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yushiku an yakuna.
The word yushiku means يقرب. There's going to, it's going to come close. يوشكو means يقرب. There's going to come a time close. نعم.
أن يكون خير مال المسلم.
ما معنى أن يكون خير المال المسلم؟ It means that the best of the wealth of a believer. The best, meaning بخير means المال أي طيبة. The best, in other words, every single thing is going to consist riba in it. Every other wealth that you see that the people are going to have in one way or another, it consists of riba. And it becomes, there's actually no one out there who can say to you, my money is 100% pure. Some of the scholars, they took that from the hadith. Do we live that time right now? A time where it's rare you can say, I've just received halal 100%. So there's going to come a time like that where the believer's wealth, the best wealth that he can have, the most purest of wealth, the one that's furthest from, what do you call it, fitan, is going to be what? Yeah.
أن يكون خير مال المسلم غنم يتبع بها شعف الجبال ومواقع القطر.
A goats and cows and sheep, and basically having a livestock. Some of the scholars, they said the غنم here is يتمثل الزرع. It actually means agriculture. That he's actually going to be a farmer. That's the best wealth a person is going to go for. Basically to go back to the old times where it, just people go back to the real stuff. What's he going to do? يتبع بها شغف الجبال. شغف الجبال is the top parts of the hills. And مواقع القطر. مواقع القطر is where the rain drops and you're trying to make sure that, you know, your cow or your goats or whatever, you could, what do you call it, take water from it so it can drink. Or you make sure that you go there to get the water to plant your garden, your farm. نعم.
يفر بدينه من الفتن.
The reason why he's doing that, he's running away from everybody, cities and the towns, is what? He's running away from his religion. There's going to come a time, يَفِرُّ بِدِينِهِ مِنَ الْفِتَنِ. A person cannot stay with the people anymore. It becomes so hard for him. So he has to go out and just live in the farmyard and stay there, scared. وَلِذَلِكَ the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in another hadith that Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah brought in Kitab al-Fitan min hadith Abi Huraira. ستكون فتن. There's going to come fitan. القاعد فيها خير من القائم. The one that's sitting is better than the one that's standing. والقائم, the one who is standing, is better than the one who's walking to it. And the one who's walking to it is better to the one that's running to it. من تشرف لها تشرف. Anyone who presents himself to the fitna and he says, yeah, I'll take it on, it will take him on. فمن وجد منها, anyone who can find that day, ملجأ أو معادا فليعذ به. Anyone who can find a place where he can seek aid and refuge from, then he should do so. Run away from these places. وَلِذَلِكَ the Prophet ﷺ told us, the آخر الزمان, if the Dajjal is going to come. The Prophet said, if you hear of the Dajjal's occurrence and coming, فَلْيَنْأَ عَنْهُ, turn away from it. Don't go towards him. It's shocking. Muslims are going to do it. Some people are actually going to go out of their way to go to the Dajjal. And they're going to want to see him just so they know how he looks like. This idea, if you look at the people today, that's exactly how they are. Everybody wants to know what's happening. People, the person starts agitating. His whole body starts moving if he doesn't know what's happening. Oh, please, I want to see my phone. I want to know what's happening. What's that everybody's talking about? If you have those characteristics in you today, then wallahi, may Allah protect us from the Dajjal coming out from amongst us. But those people are going to be the same people going to run to him. Honey, you don't go on a bandwagon because everybody else is on it. Allah says, وَإِن تُطِعْ أَكْثَرَ مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يُضِلُّكَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. If you obey the majority of the people, they're going to misguide you from the straight path. Allah says, وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. The majority of the people don't know. What's upon you is to follow the textual evidences in the religion. So don't present yourself to fitna and then say, I can take it on. Wallahi, it's taken more big people. The believer just takes caution and protects himself. May Allah protect us from fitna. Wallahi, this issue is very scary. It's very scary that the fitna, the way it comes and the way it goes in to a person's mind. I remember, subhanAllah, a girl got into contact with me and she said to me, brother, I used to go to university. And I met this brother I met this guy in uni, he would always come up to me and he would show interest in me. So I looked at him and I didn't find him very appealing. I said to him, look, I'm not interested in you, leave me alone. I said, I'm not interested in you. She said, the first year went by, the second year started, but he wouldn't leave me, he would come to me every single time. He kept coming to me and kept coming to me and kept coming to me. Just would show so much. If I was in the library, he would come in the library, try to sit right in front of me. He would not let go of me. He would not leave me. And she said, I personally wasn't doing it out of religious reasons. She was very honest about it. She said, I just didn't like how he looked. So what happens, he said, the second year came, or maybe the third year, something like that, she said to me, he worked out on himself. He, you know, he puffed up. He spent months in the gym, slept in the gym. And so she said, he came back to the university. She said, he looked totally and utterly different. She said, I became gobsmacked. I gave in to him, and she said, we did every haram there is. She said, after a while, my heart became connected to him. And he said, the man is not even a Muslim. She said, brother, the problem now I have is not the fact that, she said, I can't see my life without him. I can't. But she said, there's a problem. The problem is that he says to me every time when he speaks to me, she says to him, brother, she says to the guy, take Islam so we can get married. He's like, I'm not interested in Islam. And she's like, I'm in a situation where I can't see my life without him. And I want him to become a Muslim. But she said, now it's become even a more of a problem, because what he said to me in response is that, why is it that always you want to push down my throat Islam and you want me to become a Muslim? Why are you forcing me to become a Muslim? Have I ever told you to become a Christian? Have I ever told you about my religion? Huh? I haven't. I let you be the way you want. I don't care what religion you are. I don't care what religion, if we do have children together, what religion they take. I really don't care. Why are you so... Your religion must be a problem. So she said, now I'm thinking about, is Islam right? Brother, I'm confused. Why is it that my religion wants to force him? Why can't we just be the way we are? We're living good. Why can't the Islam be happy with the way I am? Fitna to shahawat turned into what? Fitna to shubuhat. It turned into shubuhat. Now she's doubtful. She doesn't know what her religion is like. She doesn't believe in it. So all I could say to her, sister, if you had a 20 pound note, and somebody wanted to give you a £5 note for a £20 note, would you take it from them? I said, however much they try to say to you, sweet, your religion is better than what he believes. There's no need for you to go down and accept it from him. The reality of the situation, my beloved brothers and sisters, is that the reality is, and the truth of the matter is, when you open yourself to fitna, however small that you might see it to be, when it goes into you and it comes in, it will come with wave. Shaytan, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. Do not follow the steps of shaytan. Shaytan doesn't do anything one time. He's a gradual. He builds his case gradually. And he will make himself get there with you gradually. And it's happening. Kids are starting off with shahawat, and it's leading to shubuhat. Wallahi, be very careful. It's a very serious situation. That's just one case from cases. Me and the brothers, sometimes we just get to the point, wallahi, can we even read these email messages? Can we even read them? It makes our day so bad and painful. Wallahi, stresses you out. And the reason is because, as I said today in the khutbah, is because wiqayah, prevention is not taken. Nobody's taking preventions. People are coming to you after they've done everything they've done. After they're swimming inside the problem. Our religion is about prevention, placing everything in the right place. Don't take one thing out of its place, expecting everything to be smooth. It won't happen. Now, so brothers, run away for your religion. Protect your religion.
Chapter, the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I know Allah better than all of you do. And Imam Bukhari says, and knowledge is the act of the heart, as it is referred to by the statement of Allah Jalla Jalala, but he will call you to account for that which your hearts have earned. Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 225.
Babu qawlu an-nabiy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ana a'lamukum billah wa anna al-ma'rifata fi'lu al-qalb liqawli Allah ta'ala walakin liyuakhidhukum bima kasabat qulubukum.
Al-Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, he chapted a very important issue here right now, which is knowing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, having knowledge of him, is from the greatest things of iman. But what we have to really understand is, لا يتوقف على القول باللسان. Don't think your iman is only just knowing Allah. That's not enough. ولذلك, a group have deviated from this point. And what they thought was Iman, all it means is Al-Ma'rifah, knowing Allah. That's it. If you know Allah, you're a believer. And this is the belief of the Jahmiyyah. The Jahmiyyah, they believe that the Iman is just to know Allah. So for them, if you look at it, Iblis is a believer. If you say belief, to become a mu'min, you have to just know Allah, then that means everybody's a Muslim and everyone's a believer. ولذلك, the scholars, they say, أخبثوا, the most evilest of the murji'ah is the Jahmiyyah. The belief of the Jahmiyyah, they're the filthiest in terms of belief. So when he's saying here, وَأَنَّ الْمَعْرِفَةَ فِعْلُ الْقَلْبِ, he doesn't mean this is all of Iman. Because he just previously mentioned before that the Iman is قول العمل. Okay, so don't confuse the two with one another. Okay, and then he brings the ayah: لا يؤاخذكم الله باللغو في أيمانكم ولكن يؤاخذكم بما عقدتم الأيمان. لا يؤاخذكم الله باللغو في أيمانكم ولكن يؤاخذكم بما كسبت قلوبكم. Sorry, بما كسبت قلوبكم. That which your heart has earned. نعم.
Are we carrying on, or are we going to stop for salah? Carry on.
Yeah.
And narrated by Aisha radiallahu anha, that whenever Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered the Muslims to do something, he used to order them deeds which were easy for them to do according to their strength and their endurance. They said, "Oh Allah's Messenger, we are not like you. Allah Jalla Jalala has forgiven your past and your future sins." So Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam became angry, and it was apparent on his face. He said, "I fear Allah Azza wa Jal more, and I know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala better than all of you do."
حَدَّثَنَا مُحَمَّدْ ابْنُ سَلَامٍ.
Here, Muhammad ibn Salam, some scholars, they say Muhammad ibn Salam, they بالتشديد, and some do it بالتخفيف. And the majority of them do it بالتخفيف, they say بالسلام.
قَالْ أَخْبَرَنَا عَبْدَهُ.
Abdah, his name is Sulaym ibn Sulayman. Abdah ibn Sulayman al-Kufiyu. Tiqa.
And Hisham.
Hisham here is ibn Urwata ibn Zubayr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He's the son of Urwata ibn Zubayr. Urwa is the son of Zubayr ibn Awam. Urwa is not a Sahabi, but his brother is Abdullah ibn Zubayr.
An Abih,
who's his father? Urwa ibn Zubayr. And who is Aisha to Urwa ibn Zubayr? His maternal auntie. What was Urwa ibn Zubayr's mom? Asma bint Abi Bakr. So he could just enter onto her without her wearing hijab. So he used to get so much ahadith from her. It was good for him. That's his auntie. He goes, sits with her. She just tells him narrations after narrations after narrations. And Urwa ibn Zubayr is from the Fuqaha al-Sab'a, from the seven jurists of Medina. He's from there? Seven fuqaha of Medina. نعم.
أن عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها قالت كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا أمرهم أمرهم من الأعمال بما يطيقون.
This hadith means that the Prophet ﷺ was one, if he commanded the companions to do something, he will make them do what they were able to do. He wouldn't make them do over their ability. And now this is a point that we need to observe, which is, I always mention this, and I'm always going to mention it, because I feel like every gathering is different from the previous gathering that I had. And I also believe that the reminder benefits the believers. And that is, Islam observes the essence of the people. There's always a strong relationship between al-khalqu wa shar'u. There's always a strong bond between the creation and your essence and the sharia. So don't ever think to yourself, and don't let shaitan convince you, that Islam is not applicable for you at a time or a place. No, it is the most. Are you with me? Look at the Prophet observing, his rulings are observing the people's essence. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَن يَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ وَيُرِيدُ الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الشَّهَوَاتِ أَن تَمِيلُوا مَيْلًا عَظِيمًا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَن يُخَفِّفَ عَنْكُمْ وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. Also Allah says, لَا يُكَلِّفُ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا مَا نَهَيْتُكُمْ عَنْهُ فَاجْتَنِبُوهُ وَمَا أَمَرْتُكُمْ بِهِ فَأْتُوا مِنْهُ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ. So the Sharia observes and looks at your ability. صح؟ ولذلك from the قواعد المقررة عند الأصوليين is what? المشقة تجلب التيسير. She's taken from what? إِنَّمَا عَلْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. which is that the Sharia is most befitting for you. Are you with me? So never think to yourself that the Sharia is on another wave and you as an individual are on another wave. Like Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, when he was legislating, he had no wisdom. Is that what you're trying to imply? Allah says in the Quran, أَلَا يَعْلَمُ أَلَا يَعْلَمُ Does he not know? مَنْ خَلَقَ The one who created, وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ Does he not know the one who created? What's good for his creation? Does he not know that? Are you there? Of course he knows it. Allah knows what's good for you, sisters, and what brings you your rights. Feminism is not going to bring it for you. Feminism is not going to bring you anything. Allah knows it better. Take it from Allah. And brothers, rapsters and artists and musicians and football players and whatever you guys are into, they ain't going to bring you what your body needs and your mind needs. Are you there? Wallahi, brothers, you guys can, you saw it. I'm going to say his name because we all know it. I forgot his name. One of these, he's a comedian and he killed himself. He was a white comedian. Robin Williams. He killed himself. The man was rich. He had money. He didn't just have a house, but he had houses. He was a comedian. He had fame. He had money and fame. Why did he kill himself? Money, because وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَنِ نُقَيِّضْ لَهُ شَيْطَانًا فَهُوَ لَهُ قَرِينٌ وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكًا وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. Allah says, مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ فَلَنُحْيِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْرَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Isn't that the case? They're living good, you live a good life, ikhwani, wallahi. Does that make sense? A believer stressed, he's gone through hardship, but joy comes from the religion. You know why? This cup was made for a reason. If I use it for other than what it was made for, this cup cannot handle it, and it won't be able to handle it. The same is my heart. It's the same. Inna lillahi aniya. Allah has vessels. Isn't this a utensil? A place you put water in? Allah made the heart. The Prophet said this in the hadith of Imam al-Tabarani, narrated in his Musnad al-Shamiyyin, that inna lillahi aniya. Allah has cups and vessels where he places things in. وَآنِيَةُ اللَّهِ And Allah's vessels are what? قَلْبُ كُلِّ عَبْدٍ صَالِحٍ The heart of every righteous slave. Allah pours every khayr in there for you. Now when I put the water in here, the cup doesn't become stained. It's made from this. Placing it in there. When I finish from it, you won't tell no stains. It looks good. صح? Because that's what it's made for. If I put a toxic acid in there, it will rip the cup will rip from the bottom and it won't work. That's what we're doing. We're putting toxics in our hearts, listening to music, giving our ears to people of innovation who are causing our hearts to become problematic. Wallahi, brothers. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, "Kulla man," every time a slave commits a sin, what happens? Nuqitat fi qalbihi nuqtatan sawda', a black dot is placed on his heart. Fa'in taba wa anab suqila qalbu, every time he repents, the heart is cleaned again. And if he doesn't, then the dots are made more. Take a paper, place so many dots on it. What happens? كلا بل ران على قلوبهم ما كانوا يكسبون. ولذلك the hadith of Hudhayfah ibn al-Yaman, what does it tell us? تعرض الفتن. The fitna is thrown at the heart. عودا. Thrown at it. Then the Prophet, the hadith tells us what? كل قلب أشربها. Any heart that accepts it. The Prophet told us, this is what's going to become, watch. This cup upside down. Now try to pour water in it. Would it pour water in it? Can I? Should we put it to the test? هذا هو. لا يعرف معروفا ولا ينكر منكرا. He will not realize the good. You come into him and say, "Akhi, this is good." It's like, I can't see it. ولا ينكر منكرا. He can't reject the evil. That's clear. Everyone can see it, but it's the heart. إنها لا تعمل أبصار. It's not the eyes that become blind, brothers. Allah said that. إنها لا تعمل أبصار ولكن تعمل قلوب التي في الصدور. It's the heart that becomes blind. Are you with me, brothers? Protect your hearts. ولذلك look what Allah تبارك وتعالى. The first thing I just said to you, the cup is a utensil, right? Allah places things in there. What was the first thing that was placed in the Prophet's heart? لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به إن علينا جمعه وقرآنه. Muhammad, don't read the Quran with us. We're going to place the Quran directly in your Pour it in your heart. وَإِنَّهُ لَتَنْزِيلُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ نَزَلَ بِهِ الرُّوحُ الْأَمِينَ عَلَى قَلْبِكَ لِتَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ بَلْ هُوَ آيَاتٌ بَيِّنَاتٌ فِي صُدُورِ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ. Is it rocket science? Look at all of that. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى اللَّهِ says أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ لَا اللَّهُ says أَلَمْ يَأْنِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْ تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَمَا نَزَلَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ وَلَا يَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلُ فَطَالَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْأَمَدُ فَقَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَكَثِيرٌ مِنْهُمْ فاسقون. What happened here? فَطَالَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْأَمَدُ. The time became long, became distant from the Quran and the remembrance of Allah. فَقَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. Their hearts became tainted. So the heart needs cleaning, brothers. Before I put something in this cup, what do I have to do? If I want to drink Fanta after I drink Coca-Cola, but there's Fanta, Coca-Cola in there. First of all, drink what's in there, and then you can get more, right? You can get the other flavor that you're looking for. If our hearts are filled up with sins, we need to pour that out first. Then, inshallah ta'ala, knowledge and every khair there is that can enter the heart. Wallahi, brothers. Inshallah ta'ala, we'll stop now. And after the salah, we will carry on.